Hi children, today we'll start standard 8 civics, chapter number 1, Introduction to the Parliamentary System. In this chapter, we will learn the machinery or the system of government as given in the Indian Constitution. We'll learn about the government. Let's see. These questions, now some of the questions are given. What is the parliamentary system of government in India? We have Prime Minister. But why there is no Prime Minister in the United States of America? What is the difference between parliamentary and the presidential system of government? These questions would lead us to conclude that every country has a different form of government. Each country has a different form of government. Before we go ahead, to understand different types of government systems, let us give information about the main branches. First, we'll study about the main branches of the government. The function of the legislature is to make laws. The function legislature makes the different laws and rules. The executive implements the law and the judiciary provides justice. The executive officer implements all the laws and the judiciary provides the justice. Nyaya deta aplyala. The functions of these organs, their jurisdiction and limitations on their power and the interrelationship between these organs are decided by the constitution. These all are decided by the Indian Constitution. It is the nature of their relationship that determines the system. How is the nature that determines the system of government of that particular country? There are two main types of governments. Parliamentary system and presidential system. Now we will study parliamentary system of government. The parliamentary system of government developed primarily in England. It was developed in England first. The English constitution is an unwritten constitution, not written, unwritten. The governance is carried out in accordance with traditions and customs and conventions. This governance is carried out as per the traditions. The British Parliament is an institution that has evolved over a period of time. After a period of time, it has evolved, it came. The parliamentary system of government, having its roots in Parliament, it has its base in Parliament, is considered as a contribution of England. India has adopted parliamentary system. We can see some broad similarities, same things, between parliamentary system of England and parliamentary system of India. But when looked at an institution level, if we look at institution level, the Indian system is different in its own content, in its own form. Let's see some characteristics of parliamentary system in India. Parliamentary system is a system of governance. The legislature of the central government is known as parliament. All the legislature of central government is known as parliament. The Indian parliament is composed of president, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. Members of Lok Sabha are directly elected by the people. Directly people elect the members of the Lok Sabha. The number of members in the house is fixed. The number, how many members should be there, that number is fixed. Elections to the Lok Sabha are held at regular intervals, at regular times. All political parties contest this election. All political leaders can take part in these elections. The party which gets more than half of the seats is considered majority party. More than half seats, the party which gets political party is considered as majority party. And the majority party forms the government. Sometimes, when no party gets a clear majority, some parties come together to form a majority. कुनाले majority मिळत नसेल तर काही parties एकत्र येऊन majority तयार करतात. And they can establish the government. This kind of government is known as a coalition government. In this way, candidates directly elect the people by some members of the party. The majority gets a chance to form the government. And that party in the majority gets a chance to form a government. The leader of the majority party becomes the prime minister. Leader of that majority party becomes the prime minister. He or she selects the candidates for ministerial positions. Finance minister. Yes, for such ministers, he selects the position from his or her colleagues. The prime minister and the council of ministers chosen by prime minister together forms the executive in the parliamentary system government. In parliamentary system, the executive has a dual, two responsibilities. An executive, they have to implement the laws. They have to actually do that laws, apply that laws. As they are the members of the legislature, they also have to fulfill the responsibilities of all the legislature. Next, the Prime Minister and Council of Ministers is responsible to the legislature. Prime Minister and the Council of Ministers are responsible for this legislature. It means that Council of Ministers have to work with legislature. It is for the reason that parliamentary system is known as responsible system of government. So, parliamentary system is called as responsible system of government. Another characteristic of parliamentary system is collective responsibility. All the collective common responsibility is there. Decision taken by any ministry or department is considered as a decision of government. The entire Council of Ministers is responsible for this decision. In next two chapters, we'll see the examples how principle of collective responsibility is brought into practice, how it is done actually. In the parliamentary system, the executive is dependent on the confidence of the legislature. This means that Council of Ministers remains in the power till it enjoys the support. Till the legislature is supporting it, that till then only this Council of Ministers can enjoy this position. If the legislature feels that executive does not work, it removes the executive from the power. If the legislature feels it is not proper working, then it can remove it from this position. No confidence motion is an effective tool of keeping a check over the executive. In the parliamentary form of government, the legislature is a supreme institution, top, final institution. Elected representative people express demands and aspirations. All the demands are expressed at the supreme government. Parliament decides on the issues of public welfare. Since it is the house of representatives of people and expresses the authority of people, it is considered as supreme body. Parliament is considered as supreme body. Now we study why did India adopt, why the parliamentary system adopted by India? Why it is, reason behind it. India adopted parliamentary system of government for several different reasons. The development of parliamentary institutions started during the British rule. The British rulers governed in accordance with this system. The parliamentary system of government in India is also in a way a product of freedom movement. We got freedom from this movement. Indians were familiar to this system. Indians were well known to this system. Many discussions took place in the Constituent Assembly. The people who framed this constitution made few changes in this parliamentary system. Discussions are on the integral part, the main part, discussions. Yes, questions related to public welfare are also an important part of this system. Members from opposite party can also take part in the discussions. They may support the government where appropriate, point out where there are shortcomings or disadvantages and try to resolve it. Next, we'll see presidential system of government. Presidential system of government can be said to be another important system of government. This type of system exists in countries such as the United States of America. This system is different from the parliamentary form. In this system, the president is the executive and is independent. No legislature can impose any rules on the government. That is presidential government. Okay, such a system is known as presidential system of government. Though the three organs are independent from each other, not dependent, they are enough connections. They have enough connections between them to work in coordination, to work with proper coordination. So some features of this government are, in a presidential form of government, legislature and executive are not dependent on each other. The houses of legislature and the president are directly elected by the people. The president is the executive head. It is the head. President itself is the head and had lot of powers. In spite of such a structure, legislature and executive keep a check on each other. They just keep a check, keep an eye on each other, supervise each other. This mutual control can lead to a responsible government. Apart from parliamentary and presidential system of government, there are other forms of government also that are followed in France, Switzerland, Germany, etc. Several countries, owing to their unique circumstances, have different systems. Several countries have several different forms of government. In the next chapter, we will study the structure, working and role of the Indian Parliament. Understood the chapter? Yes. In next video, we will study the next chapter.